there! I'm Ken. This is Canadian Retro Things. Welcome. I hope everybody out there in YouTube watching land is having a great day. Today, I'm going to look at some little tricks that you can do on your Coco 3. What's the number one complaint I hear about the color computer from non-Coco users, people that didn't grow up with this computer? All right, everybody, say it with me. The green screen when you turn it on. Even though it's been proven that staring at the color green is very subconsciously calming. I guess if you really want to change that and you have a color computer 3, there's a way you can do it, and we're going to look at that today. By the way, I'll be interested to see how I sound, because after 3 years of using the same microphone, I finally had to buy a new one because it died on me. And here we are in front of my Coco 3 with the aforementioned nuclear green screen. Ah, so relaxing. Now, in the old days, the way that most people know how to change the color of the screen on the color computer is with the CLS command, which means clear screen, and then followed by a number. So that gives you different colors. Unfortunately, it does, every time you type, go back to the green background, and when you hit enter, the entire line changes to green. But there is another way on the Coco 3. You have something called the palette command. So you've got two different palette commands you have to know. The first one is for your foreground color, which is 12. That's the color of the letters that you're typing. So I'm going to initially change this to white. Well, now that's not very readable, is it? So, let's change the background color, which is 13. That's the number you have to know, followed by a number. Let's change it to blue. There we go. Now when we clear the screen, we've got a blue screen with white writing. Kind of like an IBM computer. So now, if you were to run a program, just give me a minute while I boot something up. So I have loaded into the computer now a game that's called Death Valley. This is, of course, from one of my favorite things, a type-in game book. This is one of the Osborne ones. So this is a simple little flying through a trench game. As you can see, on this type of screen, gives you the feel of one of those old IBM style computers with the blue screen, the white letters. But wait a second, you say. I didn't have an IBM when I was a kid. I had, I don't know, let's say an Apple computer. Okay, well, you can change the palette. So what we are doing here is we are keeping it a white letters with a black background. Just like the old Apple computers, the Apple IIs. And you'll notice that I didn't change the palette 12,63 from the old one. So I didn't actually have to type that in again. It would have kept the letters white, but I'm just doing that to show you what exactly you have to type in to get this color set. Now, what happens if you didn't have a white screen when you were using your Apple computer back in the day? What if it was, say, a green screen? There you go. Now, you'll notice, of course, I didn't change the 13,0, which is the background color, setting it at black. Again, you don't have to type that in, but this is just for so you can see what you have to type in. Wait a second, you didn't have a green screen when you were a kid. perhaps then maybe you had the old amber screen. There we go. It's like playing a game, a type-in game on the old amber screen Apple II. But what happens if it wasn't even an Apple computer that you had when you were a kid? Maybe it was a Commodore 64. So as you can see, you can actually do a lot of different color sets using this palette command. As a matter of fact, I'll be right back. I'm going to write a little program that will cycle through all the different colors you can use. And here we are with a quick little program that's just going to cycle through and show you all the different background colors that you can use. Using a background color, the foreground color is exactly the same color if you choose that for the palette for the foreground. And it will also print a little number on the screen to show you which color it is. Here we go. And if you want to skip this, just skip ahead, but this is just going to quickly cycle through the 60 some odd colors that you have to choose from. And there we go, we are now into a white on white screen. Sort of a white, my colors seem to be a little bit off on the computer right now, but that's, I think, is my capture card. Normally this is a little bit whiter. As you can see, there is a lot that you can do with the palette command. As a matter of fact, there's even more that you can do. Because currently, if you use the palette 12, comma, a number and the palette 13, comma, a number, that affects only the 32 column screen. But what about the 40 and 80 column screen, you ask? Well, I'm glad that you did ask.
Hey there, I'm Ken from Canadian Retro Things, and I just like wanted to say thank you to everybody out there that's supporting my channel through liking the videos and watching the videos and like totally subscribing to the videos. It's awesome. But did you know that there is another way that you can help out my channel? I've like totally got merchandise now. And if it's not a t-shirt you're looking for, man, how about a coffee cup? Because coffee cups, they really keep you awake on those long drives to those retro shows, man. Oh, that's so good. Oh, man. Oh, yeah. That's so good. And maybe coffee's not your thing, man, but hey, everybody needs to hydrate. And there's like totally water bottles. You can get a water bottle and like have this right beside your computer while you're playing games, and it'd be totally awesome. And yeah, man, that's good. So, yeah, you can stay hydrated, you can drink coffee, you can wear t-shirts, there's other stuff too. Just check the link below, check out the store. It'll be awesome. Check you later, dude.
And we are back, ready to take a look at the 40 and 80 column pages. In case you don't know, you can simply change your computer by typing width 80 for 80 column. Or we'll do this in width 40 because it's a little easier to read. Again, there's two palette commands. You've got palette 8 this time rather than 12 for the foreground. Now the colors are exactly the same. So if we go 63, that's again going to be white. And now you use 0 rather than 13 for the background color. And again, all the colors are exactly the same. So again, we're going to go with one, which is blue. And there you go. You have your blue with white. But I can hear you saying right now, it's still got that green border. Well, it's very easy to get rid of that. You just clear screen one. And there you go. Now, as I mentioned, all of the colors are exactly the same. So, there you go with the black. Clear screen two, or clear screen one to change the borders. And there we go. There is the Apple II with the white looking. You can also change that to green or amber, just like in the other one. Or you can go with your Commodore look. And again, clear screen one to change the border. And there you go. You have your Commodore look. So now I can hear you asking, okay, fine. You can run your little basic programs like this. You can change the colors for that, but how does it affect your actual gameplay? When choosing a game to try this out on, there's a very narrow margin of games in the Cocoa world that this will work on. For instance, Zaxxon here, when you're in RGB, is in black and white. If you switch it over to composite, then it's in color. So unfortunately, Zaxxon will not work. There's also another version of games here, like Pooyan, that it is in color when you're in RGB. By the way, you're looking for games that are showing up in color on RGB. So it's in color on RGB, and it's also in color in composite. Now, as you can see, we've got the Pooyan game in, and if you do the palette command, it doesn't matter what palette command you do with a game like Pooyan, it switches it over to the other palette. Now, unfortunately, all that is happening with Pooyan is that you're just switching over to the other color set that can possibly happen when you load up a color computer. And you can accomplish the same thing by holding F1 and going reset. So that really didn't do anything. But there are some games. There are games like Lunar Rover Patrol, which meet the criteria for what we need to do. As you can see, this is RGB, and this is composite. So, not very nice looking in composite, a little bit better looking in RGB. Now, when you're in RGB, you're usually going to have the four colors of blue, yellow, green, and red. These may vary depending on the game. Now, to make a change to it, the first thing you do is put in the RGB command, which it just actually makes the colors you're about to use a little clearer. If you don't use the RGB command, then sometimes if you use two similar colors, you can't really tell the difference between them. And then you just have to change the palette of, say, the 0 to 0. So that should be the green palette on the game. We're changing it to black. Okay, so then we load up the game. And as you can see, it looks better. A lot more contrast there. But you know what? I think we can make it look even better than that. You can, in fact, change all four colors that are on the screen. Now, in this particular instance, you have green, yellow, blue, and red. Whereas green is 0, yellow is 1, blue is 2, and red is 3. So, you change those by first typing RGB. Then you do a palette change for 0, which is the green color. Let's make that blue. Now the next one we're going to change is the yellow color, which is 1. And we're going to make that, how about green? Since that is the continents on the Earth. And we have just changed the color of the Earth to blue, so that ocean parts. And now we're going to change the blue colors. Now, it had the sky color as blue, but it's the moon and it's space, so let's make it black. And finally, the red color, which was the ground. So let's change that to, I don't know, how about a brown color? Oops. 3, comma, then a brown color. Now we load Grover. Start it up. How's it gonna look? All right, well, okay, so you've got green continents with the blue ocean for the Earth, some bluish looking mountains with some green highlights on top, and brown ground. So that's changing all four colors on this game. So as you can see, you can do a lot here. You can change it to any four colors you want. You can make the game look a lot better. You could even make the game look really, really gaudy.
There you have it. A couple of simple commands, and you can change your background color or your foreground color to a veritable rainbow of different colors. You can even change some of the games to make them suit what you want them to look like. A big thank you to L. Curtis Boyle for the inspiration for this video. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed this. If you did, don't forget that a like, a subscribe, and a comment below are all things that are really helpful to the channel and are greatly appreciated. But that's all I have to say for today, so I will see you next time.